When I decided to create the text series, I was a little torn as far as how to present it, because usually when I teach, I want to teach you the exact reason why before I teach you the how, because the why controls the how. However, with texting, what I also want to do is I want to teach you the thing that will get you the biggest result for the most people as fast as possible. And so I decided to lead with that. So the thing that I see wrong in the most guys text game that I see that I coach is the following. They don't know where they're at in the interaction. They don't know if the girl really likes them and it's time to make plans, or they don't know if it's fading and they need to recover it, right? And so the most important thing I can give you right up front in a text system is a way of knowing exactly where you're at and exactly what to do next. And that's what I'm gonna give you in this video. What I'm basically gonna tell you is this. Every single text you've ever received, it all falls into the category of one of four different types of text. There are only four different types of text you've received. Those four types of texts are, number one, silence. Number two, a shit test. Number three, something sort of logical or platonic. And number four, something that's clearly positive. Okay? Every single text you've received falls into one of those four categories, or occasionally, it'll fall into a mix of two of them that are next to each other. And if you look at those categories, they reflect a gradient between the girl barely likes you to the girl really likes you. So if the girl's giving you silence, she's not that bought in yet. You have a lot more work to do. If she's giving you something clearly positive, things are pretty good, you should be making plans. And if you're in the middle getting a shit test or getting something logical, you're getting closer and closer to that positive element, okay? So here's what I'm gonna tell you. Every single time you get a text, look at the text and you can immediately categorize it as which of the four is it, or is it maybe two that are next to each other. Like occasionally, you'll get a shit test with like a logical question thrown in with it, or you'll get a logical question with a positive, right? But it's one of those four or two that are next to each other every single time, period, okay? So based on that, you know how far you are. Now, the idea is the less well things are going, the more you need to convey your personality and offer value and make the situation fun to get things going better. When things are going well, you need to close. So the mistake I see guys make is things are going really badly and they try and close every single text, right? The girl's barely responding. They text the girl, she responds 3 days later with a one-word answer, and the next thing they do is try and make plans. That's almost never gonna work. The girl's not bought in enough for that. On the other hand, I'll see girls responding so positively to guys, like sending like fucking naked pictures and stuff like that, and the guy just keeps the conversation going and going and going and never attempts to close. So when you're texting, you need to be moving things forward to a close. Okay, the end goal of texting is to get her off of the phone and in person with you, because it's a lot easier to have sex in person than it is through the phone. I haven't figured out how to have sex through a phone yet, so you need to get her in person. That's the end goal. So if you're getting silence, what you need to do very simply is what I call pinging value into the void. You're going to say something cool, fun, funny, interesting, and very importantly, you're asking for nothing in return, right? Because if she gave you silence before, it's very likely that the next response you're gonna get will get silence also. So if you send something that's very like needy or that requires an answer and then you get silence, you've massively hurt yourself in the text sequence. However, if you send something just fun and funny and interesting that doesn't require a response, one, you're more likely to get a response, and two, if you don't get a response, it's not as big of a deal. So in terms of this, when I say pinging value into the void, I want you to think of like a social media update, like a fun Facebook post or a little tweet that you'd put out there, right? Something like that's just fun, funny, interesting. Pictures, memes are great for this sort of a thing, okay? Now, on a certain more advanced level, if there's some relevance to it, that's better, right? So for example, I actually field tested this. If you send a girl a random like cute photo of a cat, a lot of girls will respond to that. However, I wasn't able to turn a lot of those responses into dates because they're responding to the cat and not to you or anything relevant, right? So it's better if it's fun, funny, interesting value offering, but also relevant to you and her in some way. Okay, so that's what you're looking for, but you're pinging value into the void. You're basically putting this interesting tidbit of your life or interesting little anecdote or cool picture or something like that out there, and just doesn't matter if it gets a response. If it gets a response, great. If it didn't, you shared something cool with her, right? The same as what you would post on social media. And actually, when we get around to social media texting, the fact that this works is one of the reasons why social media is so powerful in texting, because it's an even less invested way of doing almost the same thing, okay? So if you're getting silence, value into the void. Very importantly, Don't ask questions. Very importantly, don't try and make plans off of silence. Let's say now you get a shit test. It's a little bit better than a silence. And now, by the way, a shit test is much better than silence. Silence is the worst by far. Shit test is good. If a girl's giving you shit test, that means she's putting the time and effort in to respond to you, and she's putting the time and effort in to text you. If she's shit testing you, she likes you, okay? If girls are shit testing you, you should be able to make plans with them the majority of the time. Majority of the time, shit tests should be turnable into plans. The key thing with shit tests is just pass the shit test and that's it, okay? That's it, just pass it. And similar to in real life, the way you pass a shit test is by agree and exaggerate, reframe, those kind of ideas, right? But just pass it. Now, if you pass the shit test, what you're basically doing is you're saying, you know, you have a cool, interesting life, you're not too reactive to her, you're fun, you're playful, right? And you're not too invested in the outcome. Guys mess this up by first of all, they mess it up by failing the shit test. But assume they pass the shit test, they mess it up by passing the shit test and then asking a question. That takes away all the power of what you just did, okay? Or they mess it up by passing the shit test and then asking for plans. That makes you needy, right? The shit test pass made you not needy. The plans just prove that you're actually needy in the first place, okay? So just pass the shit test and trust that it's good enough. A lot of guys get worried. They pass the shit test and they worry that they didn't give the girl enough to respond to. If you did a good job with it, you did. And here's the important thing. You remember what it feels like when a girl texts you something a little bit difficult and you don't know quite what to do with it? And you're like, oh shit, what do I do? And you think about it, you put it back in your pocket, you pull it back out, you put it back in your pocket, and you think about it, you obsess about it, and you eventually send something. And then the second you send it, you realize it was terrible. Girls go through that process too. And if you occasionally put them on the spot and occasionally make things hard for them, you allow them to put in that effort and get invested. If every single text, you're asking them a question at the end or making it too easy to respond to, then they're never gonna have that process. Now, you can obviously go too far the other way. If the text is too bland and there's no reason to respond, that's a problem too. So the key thing is to give them a reason to respond, make it interesting enough to respond. And sometimes you can make it easy to respond, but especially on shit tests, you need to just pass the shit test and stand your ground and trust that it was good enough, all right? When you do that, you'll get some really good responses to it. When you start softening it or like hedging your bets and trying to make sure you get a response back, it just comes across as that's exactly what you're trying to do and it comes across as needy. So when you get a shit test, just pass the shit test. Don't ask questions, don't make plans, just pass it. And that's what's gonna get you from the shit test to logical conversation or something positive. That's when you're really in business. When the girl's like just conversing with you like friend to friend and really responding and adding to the conversation, or she's giving you positive things to work with, that's when you need to start making plans. And so obviously we'll go to positive. Positive is very easy to deal with. When the girl's responding to you positively, start making plans. And I didn't say make plans, I said start making plans. Big distinction there, okay? So a lot of guys, their way of making plans is, let's do tacos and drinks Tuesday at this place. Just out of the blue. That's a big problem. It's a big problem because one, you haven't screened for if she's down for plans or how into you she is and if she's ready for that. Two, you don't know her schedule. So it could be even if she wants to meet up with you, she's not ready for that. So what I usually do in terms of making plans is I do a multi-step sequence, right? A lot of times what it'll look like, and if you guys have seen my any of my text materials in the past, you'll see that I do almost the same thing every time. But usually it's something along the lines of a qualifier and then a vague suggestion and then a close. So one example might be something like, are you an adventurous person? She says yes. What's your view on drinks and witty banter with a cute boy? She responds, ha ha ha, some kind of response that's positive. Cool, what's your schedule like this week? And then nail it down to a plan, right? So it's a multi-step process. Each step gets you a little bit closer to the close, but it's not just dropping the entire close all at once. However, if you are getting positives, you do need to be at least bridging the close. You shouldn't be getting positive response after positive response and just keeping it conversational. Again, the purpose of text is to get her off the phone and off the text and into a real conversation with you in person, okay? Also, if you are getting positives, sometimes in order to make plans, you can actually use the phone as a phone. I know that's a novel concept in 2018. You can use the phone as a phone, pick it up and actually call her, because if she's responding very positively, it's likely that she will pick up the phone, especially if she just texted you, because she knows that you know that she's right by her phone. Okay, so that's actually a useful thing too off of positivity, is make the plans that way. Now let's talk about this gray area that's kind of like the finesse area, which is if you're getting logical or just like conversational responses or getting asked questions, right? So it's like, you know, I did this, how was your weekend, right? A lot of guys have trouble with that. And what you need to understand is, first of all, it's a positive. It's not just conversation, it's a positive. She's spending the time and energy to text you. If she's doing that, she likes you. So the fundamental assumption is she does like you. Remember that at all times. Remember she likes you. Now, what you're gonna do with this is one of two things. You're either going to respond back to the question or logical very briefly, and then try and do something to add some banter, add some flirtation to it. And that's if the conversation has only just started, or if the conversation was kind of like rocky at first and it's only just gotten to that logical conversational point. Okay, if it's there, then you wanna like respond to the logical, but make sure it's not bland. Make sure it's logical with a little banter, or answer the question with a little banter, a little flirtation. So what you're trying to do is add just a tiny, tiny piece of flirtation into the conversation and make it that kind of a conversation. And that's gonna get you, the flirtation part, to the overtly positive where you can clearly make plans. If it's been logical for a few texts, or it's been generally positive and now it's logical, a lot of times there you can still go ahead and make plans. So if it's in that logical question area, you need to think about not just the last text, but the overall context of the situation, and then think, is it more positive or more negative? If it's more negative, start creating the banter, like logical plus banter. If it's more positive, logical plus close. Okay, so that's kind of a gray area there. But essentially, if you look at the four types of texts, silence, just ping value. Shit test, just pass it. If you're getting logical or questions, deal with the logical questions, but then nudge it in the right direction, whether that is banter or close. And then if it's positive, get down to the close. Not in one text, but over a series of texts. So what do you have now? What you have now is this. Every single time that you receive a text, you're gonna know where you're at, and you're gonna know how to respond to it. And by the way, even if things were very, very positive and you're about to make plans and all of a sudden she's shit testing you, stop trying to make the plans. The last text she gave was a shit test. Just pass the shit test and let it escalate again positively from there, okay? So that's what you wanna be doing. You wanna be understanding where you're at in the interaction, and based on where you're at, then you'll know where to go, okay? And in general, about 90-95% of the time, this is gonna guide you very well. Over the course of the rest of the text sequence and all the lessons I'm gonna teach you, I'm gonna talk to you about a lot of specific situations that come up. I'm gonna talk to you about how to implement this really, really well and how to put this on overdrive. The one thing I will caution you, because you will have seen this video before, maybe you've seen some of the others, is understand this as a guide, but don't be completely stupid about it, all right? So what I see a lot of guys do when they learn this is they learn that when you receive silence, that means you have to go back to the drawing board and offer value. And that is true if you messed up or sent a bad text and you got silence, or especially if it was a rocky interaction, you get silence. However, if you've been like texting this girl for months and months and months, and it's been really positive and she fucking loves you, and maybe like she's been telling you like to meet her up when you come to her city, and then you're coming to her city or whatever, and then she goes silent on one text, that doesn't mean you have to go all the way back to the drawing board. At that point, you can say, look, the whole interaction has been largely positive. The last interaction before the silence was positive. So maybe there you can be a little entitled and like, you know, just understand that you deserve a response. And we'll talk about those as specific cases. But what I want you to understand is these are very, 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 very good guidelines. And they'll hold about 85-90% of the time. But that said, if your logic and your intuition tells you that the text you're sending based on these guidelines is stupid, trust your logic and intuition as well. Don't follow them completely blindly, okay? So these are the four types of text. Every text is gonna fall into it. About 85 to 90% knowing what text it is will tell you how to respond to it. But if it seems like the answer is stupid, or if it seems like the last text was completely out of context of the rest of the conversation, take that with a grain of salt and don't be completely black and white in your thinking, okay? So that's a good primer on the types of text you're gonna be receiving. As we go forward, I'm gonna explain to you the overall strategy that goes along with texting. I'm gonna explain to you basically every single in and out, all kinds of different specific cases, and how to implement this so that you're getting really, really consistent results. And remember this, just because you're getting silence doesn't mean it's over. And if you aren't getting silence, if you're getting anything better than silence, you should be able to turn it to a date the majority of the time. Okay, so if you're not getting that, you still have work to do. Keep working on it, get more numbers, get more practice, and follow these guidelines.